Disney announced this week that it has reached 118.1 million global Disney Plus subscribers, disappointing Wall Street analysts, who had reportedly expected around 126 million. Disney shares plunged as much as 8% on Thursday following the announcement but have since recovered some of the bad news has prompted Disney to cut prices. The company is offering a promotional one-month subscription for just $1.99, and launched a publicity blitz on Friday, Disney Plus Day, to promote new and upcoming streaming titles, including the movie sequel Hocus Pocus 2 starring Bette Midler and a series based on the Spiderwick Chronicle. Disney Plus has released some popular hits including The Mandalorian and WandaVision. But consumers have been turned off by the streaming service's embrace of wokeness and left-wing politics. Disney Plus is the home of the Fauci documentary, which paints a glowing picture of Dr. Anthony Fauci and even attempts to absolve China of its responsibility in the global coronavirus. The kid-friendly service also hosted an LGBTQ Pride concert this year starring drag queen Nina West, with performances of popular Disney songs reimagined with LGBTQ themes. Like many Hollywood studios, Disney is betting big on streaming, hoping subscription dollars will propel corporate growth into the foreseeable future. Disney CEO Bob Chapek expects Disney Plus to reach 230 million to 260 million subscribers by 2024. In addition to the Disney Plus subscription miss, the company also missed earnings and revenue estimates for the fiscal fourth quarter, helping to push the stock lower. Disney stock is now trading in bear territory, having fallen 20% from its March peak, according to a report from CNBC. The media giant is cutting loose other underperforming media properties, such as ESPN Classic and ESPN 2.0, earlier this month. We'll be right back.